EFF was in 'n ligte luim tydens vanoggend se hofverrigtinge en het die saak as 'n vermorsing van tyd beskryf.
That's what white people do. If they disagree with you, they always want to get you into court. They always want to arrest you. It's a pure apartheid tactics. That's what happens in the past. That's what happened in the past. We continue to see that. But we are happy to be dragged to court by the Boers. That's what makes us happy. Because it means there's something right we are doing.
Malema sê die kolonel het hom verhoed om langs Winnie Madikizela Mandela se graf te staan, maar ontken hulle het hom aangerand.
I've never done that. I mean, if I laid a hand on him, I would have penal beated him. It would have been worse than what you saw. So I don't play when I lay hands.
Afriforum sê Malema en Glossy word vervolg na die organisasie druk op die NVG geplaas het.
So dis nou 19 maande later, daar is beeldmateriaal van die gebeure. So dis eintlik 'n baie duidelike saak en dit is jammer dat Afriforum eers betrokke moes raak vanaf Januarie om druk op die NVG te plaas. Ons het hulle gedreig met 'n hof aansoek en uiteindelik het hulle toe wel besluit om te vervolg. Ons is bly ons is op daai punt. Dis belangrik dat ons 'n boodskap stuur aan Julius Malema dat hy nie verhewe is bo die reg nie. Hy's nie onaantastbaar nie.
Die NVG ontken agter dat hy gesloer het met die kwessie.
We follow due processes. The matter was not yet trial ready, hence it was not enrolled. Investigations were ongoing and we had to wait for those investigations to be concluded before we can enroll the matter on the court's roll.
Ndlozi en Malema is vandag op waarskuwing vrygelaat en moet op 10 Maart 2020 weer hier in die hof verskyn wanneer die verhoor sal begin. Eugenie Griegen, Enies, Johannesburg.